Right, so we have an Audi R8 for the weekend. And you know what that means, road trip time. Love the sound of this V10. So we're approaching the tunnel and something I've always wanted to do is a car that's really loud through a tunnel. Seen it happen on YouTube so many times. And the convertible R8 has a little button in the center here. Opens a window behind me, and that allows you to hear the engine coming through the back. And now we can take it through a tunnel.
Thank you.
whatsoever. Side roadblock. Saw a sign further back that said cars for 8 kilometers. They were literally cars. Okay, so we've made it to where we're staying tonight, and this is an absolutely gorgeous room. It's at the Simola Hotel, South Cajun kitchen as you kind of come through the door, little island over here, dining room table over there, couches, etc. There's a TV up there and what looks like a gas fireplace over there, which is quite nice. But yeah, it's a really cool sort of self-catering. It's really dark out there at the moment, so I can't show you, but I'll show you in the morning. Gorgeous views of the golf course and right across the sort of entire Nice in the mountain range. And then coming into the master bedroom, you've got a bathroom here that's got has kind of opening doors. You can see the main bed there. Okay-ish glass shower. Quite a big room, desk on the right, TV over there, and yeah, just really, really spacious. And again, like lots of windows, lots of glass, and views which you can't see right now, but they're out there somewhere. Right, so I said I would show you the view in the morning, and that is the view from our room. That is nice. The distance, the heads are just over there. You can't see them. Golf courses in front of us. Absolutely gorgeous out here. It's so ridiculously quiet. Most importantly though, breakfast is over there. So we're stopping for a quick photo op with the R8 there on this little abandoned bridge. Really pretty. It's like on this river. And you can actually rent canoes and stuff down there, like paddle down here. The next mountain pass on our little road trip adventure is the Otaniqua Pass, which is quite a fast one. There are not a lot of sort of hairpin type bends, but yeah, we'll see how it goes. Managed to get the other GoPro. I had a problem with the suction cups. They won't stick to the body, but there's that little window that I showed you in the tunnel that opens and closes. So I've got that GoPro on there at the moment. So we'll see how that lasts. And hopefully we don't lose a GoPro today. of the bangs and the sizzles. This car is phenomenal on any mountain road, but this one in particular. So good on the downshift coming off the rocks. Mountain with like cliffs like this, where you get that sound kind of just reverberating off the side, is so I figured while we're up here on the mountain, I will take you through some of the sort of outside features of this R8, because it's like there's a lot going on here. So for starters, the wheels are 20 inches. And if you just look at the size of those brake discs and the pads, like some cars have wheels the entire size of that brake disc, which is pretty cool. You've got the blacked out V10 badging over there. You've got blacked out Audi badging over there, which is really cool. The windows obviously go down. You've got the air intake over here because the boot's in the back. This is a carbon fiber finish on the back there. Proper carbon fiber, none of that fake stuff. You have the wind deflector over here, and you also have a little window that opens here. When I came through the tunnel, that's what I dropped. You can't really open this section, but you can open this section if you need to put oil in. Got a carbon fiber wing at the back, which is stationary. The GT has the sort of lifted version, but you don't get a GT in this model yet. Back to the blacked out badging. So that's blacked out, and it just looks really, really cool. This gray color on this Audi really, really suits it. I've never been a fan of the grays on the Audis, but I think it really works on this R8. Obviously you've got all the carbon fiber bits around here as well. So there's carbon fiber here, all the way up there, around here. And it's, as I said, it's genuine carbon fiber. Fuel filler cap over here, and the cockpit over here. I'll show you more of the cockpit a bit later. But that's kind of where it sits. So all in all, this is an absolutely gorgeous, gorgeous car. To open the doors, there are door handles at the bottom here. So that's kind of where they live. You slip your hand in over there. So you kind of just come grab it and you pull the door open that way. This is the release for the front. If you hold that down, it pops the bonnet. And that obviously is where you have a bit of storage space. In the bonnet itself, there's a little latch underneath here. Pop that up. And voila, you can actually get quite a lot of stuff in here. What's interesting, this bag is for that little wind deflector at the back. And then to close it, you just close it gently. Like that, press it down, and boom, it's closed. Gorgeous, gorgeous car. Looks better with the roof down. Even with the roof up though, it's manageable. And there just is carbon fiber everywhere. So like the mirrors are carbon fiber. You'll see on the inside as well, there's a whole bunch of carbon fiber around the air vents over there and on the doors over here. Obviously on the outside, as I'll show you there, and the back. So there's just like a ton of carbon, and it's really, really cool. Loving those wheels. They look absolutely stunning. One thing I will show you though is what looks to be an air vent over here that is in fact not an air vent. So that obviously is just purely a design thing. Not complaining, because it actually looks really cool. And the same kind of goes down on the grill here, because you can see I've been doing a lot of long road. There's a gap at the bottom which lets air in, but the top is completely closed up, like, and the sides. So that is just purely aesthetic with the grill, and again the blacked out badge over there. So there's an air intake there, there's an air intake there, there's a bit of air intake here, but nothing here. And the reason for that is because, well, the engine isn't in the front. The engine is the back. So the air intakes actually are these goodies over here, which is where all the air gets in. So I've got the last little bit of driving before we get back to Cape Town. And it's been an absolute blast taking this this auto. Right, so let me take you through the inside of the R8 quickly. So air vents sit over here and they have a sort of carbon fiber finish around them, which is thematic throughout this R8. There's lots of carbon fiber, you'll see even on the insides over there. Typical Audi bits here, sort of window wipers, the mirror adjusters and the opening for the hood in the front, door handle, etc., all pretty standard. The steering wheel is really cool. You have your start-stop button there, which is really lacquer, your drive select over there and your race mode over there. R8 badging, of course, and the typical multifunctional steering wheel that you find at an Audi, flat bottomed as well. Over here, you kind of have only one screen in the car. You'll see there's nothing in the center there, so you only have the screen here. And when you're jacking your phone via that USB port over there, CarPlay appears in front of you, which is actually really lacquer. I like that. You can also flick through, obviously, various things here. So you've got your car info, and you can go to the built-in nav, which lives over there, which is also really lacquer. So a typical Audi sort of display over there. If you're familiar with Audi in any way, that's pretty standard. In the center over here, again, with the carbon fiber finishes over there, the carbon fiber there, the carbon fiber there. There's carbon fiber everywhere here. Air vents. This is the climate control. You have heated seats in here, which is really useful when you top down on a cold day. Fan, temperature, and circulation over there, all the buttons, etc. There is a charging mat in there, which is quite lacquer. Your phone goes there. There are two USB ports, an auxiliary port, and a different charging port. Traction control, start, stop, standard stuff. Audi gear lever over here, pretty standard again. Volume control and a slot for the key. This is the MMI touch interface, which allows you to kind of write on it. They've had this around for a while. Also, again, very, very, very standard Audi stuff. Over here, you can drop that little glass window that sits behind you, or take the roof down, handbrake. And in the center here, you can have two cups, which is quite lacquer. So you can have cup holders, otherwise you close them up, and that's a cool elbow rest. Very small cabin, very tight, very, very, very driver focused, which I won't lie, I'm not complaining about.